and students, for the past two theory classes, what you will learn? You have learned that there is a difference between the cash book and the passbook. So we are going to reconcile the cash book and passbook, that how we have tallied the trail balance. Like that we are going to tally the cash book and also passbook. So many timing differences we have discussed about timing differences, and we have discussed about the favorable balance, unfavorable balance, format, how to write the format, everything we have discussed. In your book they have given this format. This you have to, before start writing the sums, you have to start write this format, and then you can proceed to write the sums. So I will explain this format. Already in the timing differences, what are all the four items want to add, what are all the four items want to reduce, I have explained this. Even though in your book they have given, so you can write this format. That is the procedure we are following. You have to write this format and start writing the sums. Balance as per cash book means it is a favorable balance. See, they will give in a problem, they will give balance as per cash book, or anything they will give. Balance as per passbook they will give. If they have given balance as per passbook means we are going to derive balance as per cash book. You suppose here they have given balance as per cash book. So what we have to find out? Balance as per passbook. So many items want to add, so many items want to lessen. So what are they? Let us see. Balance as per cash book. What are all the items want to add? Checks issued but not presented for payment. See, we have given the check to the creditor, but they did not present the check for the payment. So our account balance will be more, isn't it? So that we are adding. You suppose the creditor can go on. Already yesterday itself I have explained with the example. Suppose he will go to the bank and we deposit the check, means he presented the check, means our bank balance will be reduced, isn't it? So until then our bank balance will be more. You can understand the concept. It is very easy for you. Don't worry about all the add less. No need to buy out all this format. The thing I will give you two cases. The two cases you can understand, the two cases also. No need to buy out. Understand that both the two format, and then you can proceed. It is very easy for you. You will do the sum as early as possible. You can understand the sum. Then credits in the passbook. What are all the possibilities in the credits in the passbook? Interest credited in our credit means balance will be more because the liability is increasing. Bank is, as far as bank is concerned, the liability is increasing, isn't it? So our account balance will be more. Bank balance will be more. So we have to add. So which balance we are going to derive? Passbook balance we are going to derive. So the particular which balance we are going to derive in that book, the balance will increase, which can increase. In the book, balance will decrease means we can decrease the balance. That's all. Then interest credited in bank, dividend and other income. We have received so many shares or so many mutual fund. For that we are getting the dividend. So that will be directly credited in our bank. Directly deposited by a party. Yesterday itself we have come across party directly paid by, amount paid by Ravi directly. So these are all the transactions we have to add. And then any error in cash book or bank statement which has effect in increasing the balance. See, if any error, passbook they have credited twice, means for that here cash book also we have to increase the balance. So these are all the error. So that error should, if we add this error, then only we can reconcile the passbook, cash book equal to passbook. Then what are all the items want to less? Check deposited but not presented. Somebody will give check, debtor will give check to us. We have deposited to the bank, but bank did not clear the check. What we will do? Today we have presented the check. Within a day or two, it will clear. Nowadays, immediately the check will be clear. Suppose what happened to that? Don't know. So that the check is not clear.
because bank have lot of suppose the bank cashier may forget to take the check, so many possibilities are there. So check deposited but not clear, so that we have to, our bank balance will be reducing, so that we are reducing the balance. Check dishonored but not entered in the cash flow. See here, check dishonored. Check, as soon as we receive the check, what we do in our cash book, we increase the balance. But dishonored means what? Fails to pay, make the payment. In that case, our bank balance will be increasing or not? No, the party is not paid the money. So our bank balance will be reduced. So that we have to less. Then let us see what are all the debits in bank statement. Now let us move on to what are all the debits in bank statement. Interest paid by the bank. So our bank balance will be reducing. The bank will reduce the amount from our account. Insurance premium paid as per the standing instruction. Yesterday we have seen. And then direct payment by banker. Direct payment. We have given that standing instruction means who will pay the money? Banker will pay the money. So that the bank balance will be reducing. So that we have to less. See, now in my board there is no place. So that I have taken down written there. But in your note, I will send the format also. In your note, you have to write the format first. And then you have to start to do the sum. Any error in cash book or bank statement which has the effect of decreasing the balance, as per any error, it decreases the bank statement, must be decrease in the, we have to less in the statement, in the sum. Then what balance we are going to receive? Balance as per cash book means what balance we are going to receive? Balance as per passbook. So let us move on to the first case. Already you have completed the format, you know very well, isn't it? Format also, format. This is a format, girls. This is a format. And each and every sum, yesterday I have told you, bank reconciliation statement hitting, you have to write. And then you have to write particulars. Instead of debit and credit, you have to provide two columns. That inner column should be, you have to write both the column amount. Now, let me explain about the first case. See, in the first case, balance as per cash book and overdraft as per passbook, both are same. For both the one, we are going to follow this method. That is, add if they have given balance as per cash book means, suppose if they have given balance as per passbook means, what are all the items want to add the transaction which increases balance as per passbook, because which balance we are going to derive? Passbook balance we are going to derive, isn't it? So, bank balance as per cash book, they will give in the sum. We are going to prepare bank balance as per passbook, we are going to identify. So, the opposite book, what are all the balance, the transaction which increase the balance, which increase the balance of the passbook must be add, and the transaction which decrease the balance as per passbook will be less. If we do this, we can get the balance as per passbook. Suppose they have given overdraft as per passbook. We have to do or add the transaction which increase the balance as per passbook. The same method we want to follow. We have to reduce the transaction which decrease the balance as per passbook. So what we can derive? We can derive whether balance as per cash book. Are you clear, girls? We can derive. They have given passbook means what? We can get the answer. We are going to get the answer the opposite book only. Are you clear? See, they will give the balance as per cash book. We can get the opposite book only. Then come to the, this is a primary, this is a first case. It is a very simple thing, girls. Next, let us move on to the second case. I will do the sums, then only you will be very clear. You will get a clear idea about the sum. Then, second case. In that second case, they will give balance as per passbook and overdraft as per cash book. both are same. In one sum, they will give only one alone. They won't give both. See, I am telling that both are same. So we are going to follow the same method for both the balances. If you want to find out both the balances they have given, you want to find out the bank balance as well, cash book, if they have given overdraft as well, passbook means we can get the answers in balance as well, cash book, or overdraft as per cash flow. So many cases are there. Suppose they have given balance as per passbook means what are all the things you want to add? You can add the transaction which increase the balance as per cash book. So they have given the passbook balance. Which balance we have to identify? Cash book. So what to do? To bring the cash book to that passbook equal, we have to add what are all the transactions, increase the balance as per cash book. Then what are all the transactions which decrease the balance as per cash book? Means how can we identify? For that identification only, I have explained the format which is given in your book. And also yesterday also timing differences I have clearly explained. So now let us get into the sum. Illustration sums. Illustration 2, illustration.